Greetings, humans, and welcome to Empyrion, Galactic Survival. And isn't this a gorgeous world? We are playing on Landstryder's server. I am the cybernetic life form known as Twitchi, and I've come to you in the guise of your most infamous and talked about world leader to ease you in this transition from real world to fake. Oh look, we got a little dude here. Hi, dude, how you doing? Let's move back in here. This is, as I say, Empyrion Galactic Survival. This is all about surviving, crafting, getting a resource, watching out for little alien dudes here. And our aim at the moment is to build ourselves a base. What is this thing? We have sort of the classic interaction with the world devices. We have some gun. Did he just fire something? No, it was a dandelion seed. Look at that, beautiful. We have the standard interaction with the world stuff. We've got a gun. We have a drill to be able to shake the world around me. I kind of wish I hadn't destroyed that grass now. I wonder if it'll grow back. This is something that I am not aware. We have a chainsaw for cutting down trees so we can go and get ourselves some wood. And in here, well, this is kind of my all-purpose crafting table. You can see we can go inside here. We put down a load of items in the inventory, and then we can pull completed products from this. Now, you might be saying, hey, Twitchy, this is actually a little far in for the game. Why didn't you bring us in at the beginning when you were dropping in on the drop pod? And that's a very valid point. I did indeed drop in on a drop pod just over there. Unfortunately, I was recording a stream with Landstryder at the time, and for some reason that I am totally not sure about, I got absolutely no game or Landstryder audio or Discord audio. A little bit of a shame, because we got up to great things such as... I may have not reloaded my rifle. This is way cool. Everything that I like about sci-fi games in this. Which was all good fun. And now I'm looking around for somewhere to make my base. Now, I kind of think here looks really good. We got some copper over there. There's a little set of trees in the background here. It's relatively flat, whilst also being quite interesting to look at. So, yeah, I think I am actually going to set up somewhere around here. Now, to do this, we need to build something. And it's called a base call. Ooh, hello. What are these? I think these are all safe. I think these are safe things to do stuff with. So the base core is made inside this survival chamber, as you would imagine. Let's have a look. I need to transfer a few things across. Sorry, my very fuel inventory needed to be emptied out. Hey. So these guys are called lizard mules. They're nice. As far as I'm aware, they're walking meat stalls? What am I talking about? If we have a look in my rifle here and take an aim, you can see that their names are written underneath my scope there, so that's pretty good. We get to know what everything is called. Okay, so with all this stuff transferred, let's have a look inside. We're looking for the core. Now, this is in the end, so we can build this starter base, but the core is actually an item. Oh, yes, I do. It's inside the components. So at the top here, you can see we've got a few tabs. This one's food, weapons and tools, base building equipment. These are all the sort of the base materials, ingots and glass plates and stuff like that. I thought we were going to be in a little bit of trouble there, but turns out not. And then over here, we've got components. And the core is the thing I need to create. Yeah, we're missing computers. You can see on the right-hand side of my screen, we've got the whole list of what needs to be built to make the thing that I'm trying to build. Now, normally, when we have upgraded and got ourselves a full base up and working, I can just click on this and it'll go and make all the background stuff. But as we are just starting the game, we need to go and make ourselves 5 computers. And no doubt, once we've made these 5 computers, they're going to eat some stuff. Ooh. Turn it back on. They're going to eat some equipment that I really needed for the core. So let's let these make through. Thankfully, you can just kind of leave these in the output. The output and the inventory are joined. They are one. You treat them as a single item. So when things come out of the output, you can just leave them there. So we then want the core. Thankfully, nothing untoward got used up there. So that's all good. Just wait for this to tick over. Every now and then, I see the little baby lizard mules having a rough and tumble on the outside there. It's great fun. I love watching the game mechanics tick over. Well, the game environment tick over. It's always nice to have a bit of a verisimilitude to the world. The next thing I want to make is a whole load of building blocks. Now, these steel blocks are not what I want. I kind of just want the concrete blocks. Now, this requires stone. Where are we going to get stone? Well, funnily enough, I think I have an idea. Okay, there are... There is a copper deposit here. I'm not actually after the copper deposit in any way, shape, or form. Ooh, what a jump. Can't see what's going on. I'm going to get off my bike here. Am I going to get off my bike here? I don't know. Let's press Alt and get free camera on the go. It's a bit hard to see what's going on. Okay, I'm going to go literally over to this mountain and start digging a little mine shaft, a little tunnel, a way through it. Who knows? By the end of building the base, we might actually wake our way all the way through. So I'm gonna wander. Oh, I really wanted the lights to stay on. Okay, well, all I'm gonna do in this dying light is we're gonna wander up to the wall here and just start drilling through. I would show you how like lovely this looks from the outside, but nighttime is approaching. In fact, according to my time just underneath my map there, we are now waiting for sunrise. I have to pick up some crushed stone. Did you see that? There we go. That's the crushed stone we're looking for. I'm going to pick that up. I need lots and lots of this. So you can see in the bottom right that I am working through my ammo here. This stuff runs off biofuel. I'm not entirely sure how we make more biofuel, so I'm going to have to watch out for that. I'm really just looking to make a small platform first so we can set down a construction area. Oh man, it's dark. So I've been digging for the majority of the night, and you can see that I've got a nice big hole on the go here. I've managed to collect up 99 bits of a crushed stone. That's pretty good. Used up the vast majority. Well, not the vast majority. I've used up an entire can of biofuel on my drill here. I did get jumped by a night raptor. That was pretty hairy stuff. Literally last second managed to whip out my assault rifle and deal with him. Oh no, it's my motorbike that's causing the noise. So now I'm going to go back to my base, if I can remember whereabouts it is, next to the water, and start converting this stone into concrete. I suppose I could technically have brought this along with me, and then I could have been doing the conversion over there. But I'm starting to get too much stuff in here. I'm starting to get to the point where I can't carry it all. So to make this work, first we need to make all the rock dust. Now, you see me clicking them. If I shift click, I get 10. And if I control click, I get 100. So we're just going to double control click and sit about and wait, because this is going to take a while. And of course, the final thing left to line up is all the concrete blocks. I'm going to do like 200 or 300 concrete blocks. I don't think we're going to get that many. If you look here, it takes one cement per concrete block. Okay, maybe we will. I'm looking at about 150. So this should be interesting. Oh, also, you can see I had already pre-made a load. I've completely forgot about that. Let's have our mind blown. Landstryder was telling me this is the quickest way of blowing your mind. Oh, and he was right. Oh, I was expecting a small radial wheel with maybe a couple of slopes on. Wow, look at all these shapes. And we can make any of these. Any of these. Okay, so we're obviously going to have to start with just a flat base. But wow, look at this. We got some sloped walls. We can make like thin outline walls. Is that a one concrete block for it, though? It is. Okay, that's kind of okay. That's kind of okay. Wow. Yeah, you were right, Landstryder. Mind blown. Oh, man. Has that been there the whole time? In fact, I know that wasn't there, like, yesterday when I started, like, selecting this place. Let's go and check out whose place that is. Okay, so this is definitely it. I'm super on the lookout for guns, because I don't want to get shot by this thing. I know that the terrain generation bases can have some real severe weaponry on them, so I'm just kind of taking my time. Oh, is this aloe vera? I will take that. Also looking for plant fiber if I can. That's pixie stalk fiber. Awesome. So aloe and fiber go together to make bandages, which is one of the low level healing tiers. That's looking good. What is that? Snake face. I wonder if anybody's claimed this yet. Oh, I'll take some more fiber, thanks. I find aloe all over the place. This is the first time I've actually found fiber. I'm not seeing much going on here. No, it's super quiet. Let's put the old jetpack on. Jetpacks are always very important to the spacefarer. Oh, this is nice. Look what we got here. Are these things to have a look inside? They are. Oh, I'll take these. Thank you. Oh, look, medical bay. This is what we want. Oh, I need some healing. Oh, what is this? What is this? It's a medical station. Your health level is increasing. I'm just going to stand here. This one. This is the medic station. My bad. So that's the cloning station. This is the medic station. I wonder how we make this. biohazard symbol. Little bit worried. Hello? Oh, it's just the toilet. That's all right. Lots of really good stuff that at some point I'm going to have to come back for, but I don't quite have the capacity at the moment. No medical supplies. I was promised medical supplies. Let's walk out of here. So there is also this building here. Let's go and have a look. I am seriously in two minds about whether just to take over this place or not. I mean, it'd be nice. R&D lab. Wow. Just wow. Look at this place. Look at this place. Access the scanner. Hydrogen. Nice. Not quite what I'm after. Okay, well, that was a fun little trip. But now it's the middle of the night, as you can tell by the fact that I have to get my torch out. So I think what I'm going to do is just build myself a structure. I'm not sure if there's any good way of catching a time lapse. I know I've got this little drone thing that I can use. I just press F5 and it pops this out. But I can't then control my character whilst looking like this. So I'm not sure how that would work. If there is a way of doing so, that slime over there is quite a thing. I thought I'd wait till morning so I could show you guys what the building actually looks like. And I've got to say, sunrises on this planet are pretty nice to look at. The fog is lending a certain je ne sais quoi to the area. But we're going to build a base, and we need to start by placing down what's called a base starter cube. Now, we need to think hard about this, because this is how we orientate the build from this point going forwards. And I'm looking at this view over here, and I kind of want to keep this view as a sort of a window area, and that will probably mean that this view is another one, keeping this on the corner of the building. I don't know whether that is a good idea, a bad idea, or one that definitely needs some work, but I'm going to place it just like that. And it is literally just placing the base, and suddenly it is something that is ours. You can see on the map, we have another little symbol there. But this is a terrible base. Who likes bases like this? We're going to build off with a little bit of concrete here. Just try and make a nice big floor. Now, I'm not going to go through this entire process with you. For one, it's still really dark. I may have started a little bit early. And two, well, I'm already getting a little bit late in this video, so let's move this on. Okay, so now that the sun has risen properly, I can show you one of the best features of the building in this game. If I just look at this block here, point and hold down my click, then come all the way across. Unfortunately, I have picked a size that is about three blocks too long, but this is the click and drag option on the building. I believe you can also do a plane. But I'm not quite au fait with that particular style. Let's try it together, shall we? Let's pull it out. No, it doesn't work like that. Control. Control is the button you want. Look at that. Oh, we are going to make a big base. Okay, so it's more of a platform than a base, but hey, that's kind of what we've done. I've literally used all the concrete. I kind of started playing around with a few decorative designs on the side before I realized that this sort of thing was going to happen. So I kind of left that in favor of trying to extend the base out a little way. And then I kind of ran out of concrete here. And I spent a lot of biofuel on getting all the materials for this concrete. So there we go. Great big platform. Now, a few of you might be wondering, what is this thing in the right of my screen below the map? The one that gives equip your base, place generator, place fuel tank, and stuff like that. Well, that is what we need to do right now. And thankfully, most of it is got from in here. So if I have a look, and of course, have a look in the devices panel, you can see that we need the fuel tank generator, and we needed to activate the base. So what do we need for this? Metal components and cables, relatively simple to do, and also metal components, control devices, and computers. So I'm gonna craft all that up. So a large part of this game is standing around waiting for the... Well, you don't have to stand around. I went for a walk about to see what plant materials I could scavenge. But a large part of this game is trying to find stuff to do whilst the crafting happens. Did I not make enough cables? I did not make enough cable. Wow, would you believe it? What am I missing for that? Copper. So we actually need to go on a bit of a mining mission. Ah, disgraceful. Hang about. Oh, raptor. What's sharp? Anyone else around? I could do with some food, to be honest. Is that enough to kill it? That wasn't enough to kill it. Oh, look at that range. I have an open wound. Let's use a med kit on that. Okay, that was nice. That was nice. So I should have actually had enough stuff to make all this opening quest materials when I landed on the planet. Unfortunately, I've been kind of walking around a little bit with Landstryder and doing a few things. Helped build a base over yonder. Once again, if you want to see all of that, go and check out his streams that he does. There are machines and vehicles and stuff that can do this a lot quicker, and we'll probably get to them next episode. I just want to get a base up and started to begin with. I also want to show you guys prefabs. Now, we could have built a prefab base, but if I'm going to have essentially a box on a platform, I want it to be my box on a platform. So that's what we're going to do there. Oh wow, that was like actual work there, having to like make stuff up and wait around and like go and find more materials. Oh, it was crazy. So I'm gonna actually put my fuel tank in the floor. I know this seems a little crazy, but this means that I can access it from the top when I'm in my base, and I can pop stuff in there. In fact, where are my Promethean fuel tanks? I bet I haven't got any. I've got some pellets though. Let's make some up. Okay, so I'm going to pop four of those in there. I'm also going to take this generator and I'm going to stick it to the bottom. Now, somehow I can rotate this around. That's not the rotation I want. Oh, is this? No, this is page up and down. That's not what I want. Ah, so when I press the delete key, I can rotate around different axes. Ah, that's pretty cool. I'm going to pop that there, and that should be my small generator hooked up to my fuel tank. Now, obviously, if I was going to be a completionist, I'd like to put two fuel tanks next to each other there. But we're going to just go with that to begin with. Now, the next thing we need to do is place a large constructor. And I know what you're thinking. Oh, no, loads more crafting. But it's okay. I've taken care of this before now. I've made everything that we need down there, I really hope. Oh, no. What are we missing? A whole load of stuff. Ah. Cobalt has become a real issue in my life. But we will sort that out at some point. Right now, we need to place this large constructor. Now, where are we going to make our construction crafting area? That's the word I'm looking for. I just used the word constructor and for some reason that totally threw me off. Where are we going to make our crafting area? I think maybe over this way. Yeah, I like that. We're going to go with that. It's got a little hatch on the side. That's nice. I'm not sure if that is something that can be accessed directly, like with a conveyor or anything like that. But if I press F, you can see that I'm basically faced with the same thing as the survival constructor, but I've got a whole load of other things that I didn't have beforehand. Walkways, trusses, some like, I can build like my vehicles up here. We've got some decoration stuff. Just suddenly all the options are open to me. But we're not quite done with the quest. Oh no, we need to look at this and press Y. There we go. That is done. I'm going to turn it back off. You can see there's a little indicator there on off. But that's because there is a drone. There are drones in this world. They are quite large, maybe four blocks of this big, something like that. And they come at you with miniguns and cannons and stuff like that. And I'm not quite ready to deal with that because we need to add a turret and ammo box and add O2 and food production. Now, I'm not too bothered about the O2, but the food production and turret sounds like a good idea. So as well as being expanded, it also has been limited. You'll notice there's no food slot on this side. But we don't need to build that. We need to build a turret. And this should be in devices, but it's not. Because I need to show you guys something else. If we come into our tab screen and go onto our tech tree, yes, there is a whole load of stuff. And I mean literally loads of stuff. You can go that way and you can go down this way. Now, I am looking for the cannon turret. Of course I'm looking for the cannon turret. Why would I not be? I have got a lot of points available for unlocking. I think that's because I've not really done too much. But that's the cannon turret. Sorry, I've not done too much progression whilst walking around and doing a lot of stuff with other people. Oh man, guys, I really do not have the best of luck. So I was driving my motorbike over to get some cobalt from over there. I managed to get it. I came all the way back. I jumped down this slope on my motorbike and I died. Just straight up died. I saw all my stuff, like all of my stuff, drop down to the floor in a little container box. I came running back to my motorcycle, which I've now moved back to base. And there's no stuff here, which makes me very, very worried because I don't have a drill. How am I supposed to do stuff with a drill? It was literally like right there in that slope. So I assume It's dropped underground.
Oh, I can make a drill. Oh, that is so good. I haven't turned the power on, but that's fine. I'm going to line up a few things. Chainsaw. Do I need the multi-tool? I don't think I do. I do, however, need a load of bullets.
So I thought I would be done collecting all these tools and stuff and getting myself back to normal. But of course, seaweed is... Well, it's not seaweed. Biofuel is a thing to make the drill run. Unfortunately, I wasn't trying to slip down there. But if we have a look at my drill, you can see bottom right, drill, ammo, zero. I need biofuel, which is made from this stuff, which is really hard to get to. Swimming in this game is a clunky. Oh, you. Let's put my helmet back on. That noise is so unsettling as well. I know I was like dying for oxygen, but I don't sound like that when I've been gasping for air. I'm normally coughing a lot and spluttering and being like, which isn't quite the same noise. Thankfully, my base is right next to Seaweed Mecca, so I managed to grab a whole load, 67. In fact, that is more than I even had to begin with. I'm just gonna supercharge all this stuff here and see how much we get here. Now that I've done this, I need to go back and get a whole load of cobalt again because I'd managed to grab loads, but then lose it, obviously. Oh. Oh man, I'm going to die from food poisoning. Ah, so I had a little bit of an issue where I have obviously lost my survival crafting thing. So I was like, oh no, I'm just going to eat some raw food. Yeah, of course that is a bad idea. But now I'm super worried about losing all my stuff. So let's pop all this in here. Oh man, like super worried about losing all my stuff. Could you imagine what's going to happen? Like, these are all down here now. Okay, so is health still going down? Is that actually what's happening here? Where do I get a reader? Yeah, it's actually... I'm going to die, guys. Once again, we're going to just sit here and watch this 40-second countdown. Oh, it's terrible. I suppose while we're waiting for this to die, I might as well have a look. Base, does this have the survival generator in it? Is that something that I can make around here? I'm not seeing it there. How about the miscellaneous? You know it's going to be in here somewhere, right? Promethium core, oxygen generator, cargo boxes. I don't actually see it. Tools, maybe it's counted as a tool. Well, there's the portable work light. That was something I was looking for earlier, but no, that's not. A texture and symbol tool. There we go. Food poisoning. It killed me. Well, I suppose you can see the reloading process here. You are dead. Yes, I am dead. Please let me click the thing to carry on. Loading the game. I would like to go from current location. Thank you. I'm not going to go for a fresh start because that would be horrible. Thankfully, we are just up here. Let's see if... Oh, well, I wouldn't have dropped a drop box because obviously all my stuff got put away. Okay, so I have another issue. Obviously, with the death of myself on the motorcycle, I've lost my survivor constructor. This means I have no way of making food. That's why I died from food poisoning. Disgusting, right? But you can see that the tutorial quests on the top right are asking me to deal with that very thing. Food processor. Let's start with one of those. We can make that, and that's nice and easy. Oh, look, you remember I was telling you about how the larger one will go on and do all the sub-building in the background? It's doing that. That's amazing. What else do we want? We want the small O2 tank? We don't want the tank. We want a generator, don't we? Do I have a generator? I got rid of the generator. Oh, I didn't get rid of the generator. I died and I had my small generator on me. I did happen to notice that where I was digging my cobalt, there's a random player's base. And I mean literally a random player. He's not in the YouTube faction. And he just happens to have his oxygen generator outside. So I'm not sure whether I'm going to make away with that or not. Food processing. Where does the kitchen belong? I think the kitchen might be on this one. Let's use this to rotate. I am feeling this corner here. Yeah, there we go. Successfully added add O2 and food production. When did I do the O2? Okay, that's cool. Let's throw that in there. Grilled steak. I'm actually after salami. Thank you very much. Let's let that run through. I'm going to come back over here because we now want to put a turret and ammo box. Now, I'm not sure where I actually want to put my turret. I kind of feel like I actually want to put it over there. When I was playing in a single player, you see how everything is kind of connected to the same base so far. I can actually not connect it to the same base. I could just have it stood on its own elsewhere. What am I after? I'm after this cannon turret. That's nice. So you're going to go ahead and make it. Oh, look at all these things it needs to make. That's cool, though. That is Cool. We're going to let that run and take a wander over here. Oh, I'm also going to queue up an ammo box, actually. But I don't think I can actually make the ammo box or get through an entire sentence without saying the word actually too many times. No, it does not appear to be here. So let's have a look inside. No, these are all decoration. My tech tree. Oh, yeah. F3 to get into the tech tree, if you're wondering. Up at the base, we should have, like, ammo box somewhere here. This might not be actually here. There's the turret. Not in weapons either. Tools? Are you anywhere in tools? Portable work light, misc? Cargo box? No, that's not the app. Small ammo box just beyond it though. So I think, yeah, we're gonna go with this. Cargo box, I'm gonna purchase that. Small dent into the points that I have available. Do we wanna put a large ammo box down? No, we're just gonna leave it like that. So now I can come into here and hopefully somewhere in here we should spot, that's a core constructor generator. Ah, here it is in the devices. I'm sure that's where I started. All right, let's build a small ammo box as well, and then we will have both of these things set up. I think I would also like to take, let's get rid of this, a few trussings. I do like these. I'm going to take 9, but I'm going to make 10. But I think I only want to make a little 3x3 base on the floor. So I wanted to have it up here, but if I click, it goes and says, to build here, point at base, press N, and activate connect 2. So let's do that. Let's wander down this way. Let's try that. Oh, I mean, it's looking good, though. It's looking good. I mean, ideally, I want to put it up there. But we are just going to go through the tutorial missions to start with, because I'm not going to have enough materials to build the base that I want to in this time frame. The tutorial missions want me to do that. So we'll try and find another way. We're going to start with this truss. Press and hold N. Ah, there we go. Connect to base. Okay, there we go. And now we should be able to walk up this way. Now, I literally just want it here, I think. Yeah, one of those. Two. Let's go over this way as well. And then we can go this way. Okay, this is going to look amazing, I think. Don't want to do quite that many. Just to that one? No, it's... Oh, did it do it? It did do it. Okay, that must have just graphically not shown me what it wanted to do. So we pop that there. And finally, going to put an ammo box. Should have put it on that side. That's the side I'm going to be running from. So I should have put it on that side. Let's have a look inside here. It doesn't tell me what it takes. I believe it takes 30 mil ammo. So let's go and have a look in our large constructor here, because there are three types of ammo in my constructor, and I know what all of them are for. So this 50 cal is for my pistol that I don't have anymore. This 5.8 mil is for my rifle, and this 30 mil, as said, must be for the cannon. Okay, so I'm going to need magnesium. Thankfully, if there's one thing I have easy access to, look, my base is literally 200 meters away, it's magnesium. Oh, look at all these floating bits. Who did this? That's disgusting. Just going to look over here and make sure I'm not going to jump by a raptor. Not that that's happened before. So let's go down here and see what we can do. Need my drill. Okay, cool. This isn't what magnesium looks like, is it? I mean, like, obviously refined magnesium just looks like a block of metal. Not the shiniest metal, but it looks like just a block. But yeah, I don't know what the ore of magnesium looks like. Maybe post-editing me will be kind enough to splash that up on the screen so we can compare. My food bar is yellow. Oh man, that's terrible. Let's go over to my food processor and see what we've got in here. Hopefully the salami has been made. Well, guys, I was just about to go on for a massive line of quests to make my little farming area, but I've realized we are coming close to the end of this episode. That really just gives me one other thing that I want to tell you guys. This is actually a public server. If you want to come along as well, and guessing by the way that you've made it all the way to the end of this video, I think you might be a little bit interested. If you want to come and play along, oh, it looks like it can only go so far from my character. Oh, interesting. You can indeed. We are on the full list of public servers. If you just search for Landstryder's Realm, we do require a password. But here's the secret word, guys. Strider. Spelt just like Landstryder. Come on in. come and say hello. Try not to grief. I mean, you know, it's nice when we're all nice to each other, but I believe we are going to be having events that are all PvP, but at the moment the server is set to PvE. And with that, I'm going to say thank you very much for joining me for this adventure. I will see you next time, where we are indeed going to go around and do our farm plots, also expand our base out, maybe give it some walls, and start work on our first proper vehicle, a hovering mine vehicle. But I will see you then when we're going to do that. Bye! I can bounce off me. Awesome.